Welcome to JASP Tutorials. Today, I'll introduce the new network module, which allows you to estimate novel network models from data and graph the results. Our example file contains responses from 2,800 participants who completed the Big Five personality inventory. This inventory is used to characterize a subject's personality into five main dimensions: agreeableness, extroversion, neuroticism, openness, and conscientiousness. This data also includes potentially important covariates, such as gender, age, and level of education. In this context, a possible research question could be whether the items for each of the five personality dimensions form separate clusters in a network. To perform a network analysis, we start by selecting all variables that we want to include as nodes in the network. We then drag these variables to the dependent variable field. Immediately, JASP computes the network and prints general information about its size and the connectivity between the nodes. By default, we're estimating an extended BIC GLASO network. This estimator automatically detects the correct measurement scale of our variables from the raw data. This means we can use this estimator for ordinal as well as continuous variables. To graph the results, we can just tick the box Network Plot. The variable names are plotted inside the individual nodes. Next, we can color the network to make it easier to interpret. For this dataset, we want the nodes to be colored according to the personality dimension that they measure. We can do this under the field Graphical Options. To color the nodes according to the five dimensions of personality, we need to have a grouping variable in our dataset. The grouping variable assigns every variable to a personality dimension. For example, the first five variables of our dataset, A1 through A5, all load on the factor agreeableness. Therefore, the first five entries of the grouping variable simply contain agreeableness. Now we can choose our preferred color scheme. We recommend the colorblind scheme, since these colors will be distinguishable for everyone. We can see that the items that belong to each of the five personality dimensions also cluster together in our network. Long variable names can make the network graph unclear and confusing. In these cases, we can choose the option Show Variable Names in Legend. Naturally, this displays a legend next to the network graph. As always, we can copy and paste the graphs directly into our text editor, or alternatively, we can download them in a range of popular image formats. It's also possible to analyze separate network structures for different subpopulations. For example, we can assess whether the network structure is different for men than for women. To accomplish this, we can include the covariate gender in the Split By field. To analyze individual items within the network, we can examine the centrality plot and table. Here we can view information about how well our variables are connected within the network. We can also obtain a table with the weights matrix of the network by clicking on Weights Matrix. This table contains the strength for each connection. But be careful. The interpretation of this strength depends on our chosen estimation method. For example, the default extended BIC GLASO estimator calculates the regularized partial correlations between all nodes. However, we can also choose other estimators, for instance, simple correlations. If you want to investigate the accuracy and stability of your estimates, you can use the bootstrap option. More advanced options for the analysis can be found under the analysis options. In-depth information and a reference list on these options can be found in our help file. These were the main features of the network module in JASP. For more in-depth tutorials, you can subscribe to the JASP YouTube channel, or follow the link in the description to go to our website. Thanks for watching.